For this tutorial, I ask you to focus on the process rather than the detail of what or why. So in this tutorial, we're going to go ahead and create, start, and manage a virtual environment. Now, if you're working with Python and Django, it's likely that you're going to be working within a virtual environment. So it is really quite important that you understand and familiarize yourself with starting, stopping, and creating virtual environments. I am making the assumption that you have Python installed and you are working with Visual Studio Code. So let's open Visual Studio Code. I do have a project folder already on my desktop, so I can go ahead and select open and then go to my desktop, select project here, and then open up my project folder. Okay, so now I need to open up the terminal. So let's go to view here and let you know the shortcut and select terminal. That should open up the terminal window. Okay, I just clear that. So on the Mac, I press Command and K, and that's going to then clear the screen. So Command and K to clear the screen. The first command that we're going to utilize is the command to actually create a virtual environment. So here on the Mac, we're going to use the Python 3 space and then the M flag and then venv. So that essentially tells Python to run virtual environments. And then we need to assign a new folder to place the virtual environment within. So you can call it whatever you like, of course, but generally I'm going to be calling it venv. So that's going to create a new folder here. You can see that appears on the left-hand side called venv. The next step is to access or activate, the virtual environment. So to do that, I select or I type source, and then I need to type venv. Now I don't need to type the whole word here. There's only one folder here with the letter V. So if I type V and press tab, it will then end the command for me, or it will end the folder or file name for me. So inside of this folder, there's a folder called bin. So if I type B and then tab, because bin is the only folder that starts with the letter B, it then appears here. So then inside of bin, I need to activate. So I press A, and you can see that there's a few here with A, but it does select the first one. And you can see if I press tab twice, it then shows me all the commands or files with the letter A. So I just want activate, so I'm going to press enter there. So now I've activated my virtual environment. I'm now essentially working inside the virtual environment. So any commands here that I add or I use here is going to be within the virtual environment. Think of this, if you like, as a box inside of a box. Your operating system is a box. And then what we've done is we've created a small box within that box. And we're going to be working and building our project in that small box. Now, by doing that, what that means is that we can create a specific environment that's dedicated to the particular project that we're working with. And that's essentially the whole point of creating a virtual environment. We're trying to create an environment that's going to be prepared specifically for the project that we're working with. If we didn't use a virtual environment, we would need to set up our environment in our main box, in our main computer. Now, the problem here is that if we're working on multiple projects, we may need multiple environments. So multiple environments might include different software or different libraries that are required. And to avoid conflict, we can create smaller boxes, these virtual environments, so that we can specifically install and maintain everything required for that particular project inside of that smaller box. Any other detail or information will be presented in the main sections of your course if appropriate. Okay, so make sure that you've got some notes here. How to start, how to activate. You may be wondering, well, how do I deactivate? Most of the time you don't need to, but here on the Mac, you can just close, use the bin here. If I open up this again, you can see I'm now outside the virtual environment. So let me just show you how to get back into it. So we load up this project. We type in source, venv, bin, and activate. And you can see by this venv here, at the start of the command line here, that tells me that I'm working within the virtual environment. Like I previously mentioned, you are going to be utilizing virtual environments if you're working with Python and Django. So it's well worth your time taking some notes here and just practicing entering and exiting a virtual environment.